August is hot, and so are the savings at Appalachian Wireless, where all smartphones are 50% off, even the 64, 128, and 256 gig models. Two-year agreement required. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless and East Kentucky Network Company.
We have been following the progression of an outbreak of a disease that's killing white-tailed deer across eastern Kentucky. For several weeks, pictures and videos of dead or dying deer have flooded social media as a disease known as EHD continues to take its toll. When we first brought you the story, officials with the Kentucky Department of Fish and Wildlife were hoping that rainfall would give deer other options for water sources, drawing them away from the stagnant ponds where the midge flies carrying the disease were. Instead, rain has only served to carry the disease into new areas.
It's spread into areas that didn't have it at the beginning, and that's how it spreads on downstream to, you know, and affect new cases. So, yeah, the rainfall doesn't help.
The 2017 EHD outbreak in eastern Kentucky continues to worsen as reports of sick or dead deer continue to pour in. As of August 29th, nearly 1,450 cases of EHD have been documented in southeast Kentucky, and Officer Amberge knows that there are many more that have not been reported. But he says a new online form will hopefully make reporting sick or dead deer easier.
The Kentucky Department of Fish and Wildlife has got an online form. You can go to fw.ky.gov, and there's a link on the homepage there that you can report.
One thing Fish and Wildlife officials do know is the outbreak will end once the first frost arrives, killing the EHD-carrying flies. But that traditionally doesn't happen in eastern Kentucky until the 1st of October. In Pikeville, I'm Shannon Deskins for EKB News.